I am, when I cook, I am a very clean person. It's my bleach water. Yeah, I use bleach, this detergent, you know. And so anytime I cook, and then another thing, if I invite you over to my house, I'm going to wear gloves. I'm going to wear gloves, and because I'm a very clean person, behind the toilet in my bathroom is clean. No, but I'm a very, very clean person, and I do, like I said, I love to cook, but whenever I cook for other people, I do put on gloves. I did say that one time in a video. I think I put it in my story. I'm not sure. I don't know what happened to the video. That's why I'm re-saying it over. But anyway, got my chicken breast here, and I'm about to fillet, and then cut up. That's why I'm re-saying it over. But anyway, got my chicken breast here, and I'm about to fillet, and then cut into little squares. I'm thinking about somebody, so none of they like tacos and fajitas like me, and so that's what I'm making tonight. This is all the stuff that I use to season my chicken. See, you want to season the meat with the seasoning salt first, then you want to use your crushed red pepper, then you want to use the herb and garlic marinade, and then the steak sauce. And then you want to stir it, mix it together, and then you want to add your taco seasoning with your vegetables first, and then you want to add your vegetables. Oh yeah, this is another secret ingredient that I put in my tacos and my fajitas. If you have the extra Taco Bell packets, I don't know, I just add that shit in there. So, that's another ingredient. Now, this is how it should come out when you add the vegetables and stuff like that. I did add sugar, and I did add some bottled water, because I don't use tap water when I cook. I use bottled water only if I have to add water to something. But this is how it should look before you turn it on and start cooking it. So I'm going to put a lid over this and just let this cook on slow for a little bit. Well, for a lot of it. Maybe about an hour, 45 minutes. Then I just let my hamburger meat brown. So you probably know. I just let my hamburger meat brown because I don't believe in seasoning it before I let it brown. I let it brown first. And then, because all this juice is just gonna wipe this, it's just gonna drain the seasoning off. So I don't season my beef before I put it on. Tacos. For my tacos, I just use taco seasoning, crushed red pepper, and I add tacos. Onions, because they give it flavor. And yes, they are. I froze it. I worked today. I worked an 8-hour shift, okay? Got a brownie. The right way. I got the chips. Hard shell, soft shell. Beef. My chicken fajitas, lettuce. I got the chips, hard shell, soft shell, beef. Now, there's certain stuff that, like, I don't eat. Like I said, it's just me. So, like, if I had somebody over and they like queso cheese, then I would just make it. You know, I would just get it. But as for me personally, like, I would not have any, like, queso cheese or jalapenos or beans or rice because I don't eat that stuff. But I can't make that stuff. It's only me, so, you know, I cook food. Just put the water in there, and then I season it with my, like, lorry seasoning, garlic powder, lemon pepper, and then I have these turkey legs that's in the water. I already have one of them in there, but this is the second one. And I'm gonna open that one up and I'm gonna put it in there. Turn it on and start boiling. My hands are already done, as you can see. Yeah, cooking with Side Bitch. Hope y'all have a happy Easter. I don't celebrate holidays. It's a long story. It's a long story. That's all I'm going to say about that. But I don't celebrate holidays. I just started back celebrating my birthday. So for macaroni, I just take a block of Velveeta cheese. Or if you want to use the Great Value, the melt and dip cheese, you can use that too. Put you some vegetable oil in there, some milk. And let this melt. Put the setting on, like, low. I have an electric stove. I hate cooking with it. So for my macaroni and cheese, I usually use two different kind of shells. I always use elbow macaroni, but I tried rotini this time. Normally I just get like medium shells and I'll cook them, but this time they didn't have none, so I just and I cook them in two separate pots. I don't want them to get stuck together. So, finally got my noodles done, and I put them in a pan. And I got some butter in there. And then, I put some seasoning salt. I season my noodles before I put the cheese on there. And so, and then, another little secret ingredient I use is I put this on there first. So, I do use that. I put this on there first. And then I use my melted cheese. And then I put the melted cheese in there, and then I put the shredded cheese on top of that. So I'll let you see it when it's done. This is what you want it to look like. It's cheesy. What it should look like. I put a little vegetable oil on there so, you know, don't get stuck to the foil. Alright, so gotta separate the meat from the bone. But I separate my meat and then I put the Then I put the cabbage. Then I have some greens that I also did. So I'm going to put those in there. And then some okra. And the turkey meat. That's my favorite little vegetable dish that I make. And spaghetti on here, my sauce already made. And my noodles is waiting for them too. I guess I could turn it on. And so that's why I cook my smoked turkey legs first, because that's the water that I'm gonna use for my cabbage. Look at that. See that seasoning? That's how you know that's seasoning and it's spicy. Strawberry and cream cheese. That's some high shit. I was these things coming out pretty good. It's greens, cabbage, okra, and turkey meat. Looks pretty good. So you just layer butter, then you put your nutmeg on top of the butter. Your brown sugar, then your white sugar. And that's it. Then you start a new batch of yams. Like I said, start a new layer. After you put your nutmeg on. And then you put more of your butter, your nutmeg, then white sugar, and brown sugar. And while it's cooking, you want to add another layer of sugar, brown sugar, to it while it's cooking. Yams cooking, they almost done. Got my spaghetti sauce.
got to bust my cornbread. Can't have cabbage and greens without cornbread. My state kind of look like Africa. My potatoes and onions. And broccoli and cheese.
Steak. Dear okra. Creamy garlic shell for tonight. These is my yams, my cheese for my macaroni and cheese. That's what I had to make. I had to make the yams and the macaroni and cheese. These is my noodles. Being at home, cooking at home is great.
Thank. This is the one I was sending everybody. Look how you got a ding. Shaking that
more. This is what we do on Thanksgiving, y'all. We have fun. It's my stepmom.
Look at this
and
here.
My mom.
Oh my gosh. That is stupid.
Oh, that's what I've been sending everybody.
John, is this enough?
You think? Yeah. That's fine.
It's all over.
Yeah, that's okay.
That's what I've been sending everybody, Sarah. Look at this one. One Tony sent me back. Look here.
Yeah, that's stupid too.
It ain't stupid.
It is.
It is not.
That juice is gonna cook them some more anyway. Do you want more juice than that or?
Mm-mm.
Yeah, that's enough. You shouldn't have to use so much.
Yeah. So everybody, this is who I learned how to cook from.
But he does it better.
DeJuan learned. He, I ain't gonna say he a master chef or nothing like John. But John, DeJuan can cook a little bit. He can do a little something. Because, let me tell you, he used to make these chicken leg quarters. He would make these leg quarters.
That's turkey ham. And then that's regular ham. I don't eat pork.
Yes, ma'am.
Dressing.
This equivalent, Alexis, when you go to your, it's right. Right at the corner of the
lake,
across from Home Depot. You
gotta
turn right
instead
of that's left. That's the macaroni cheese I did. No, Kroger is to your right. Kroger is in the platform right next to Home
Depot.
Where
old Dix used to be.
Remember where Dix used to be right there?
It's still
made
up like this.
It's right there. If you got to Home Depot, it's in the plaza across from it.
Famous sweet potato pie.
Home Depot right there.
You know where
Dix used to be.
You know where
my mom's made pound cake. It's my lasagna. It's my sauce. Every year we have Ohio State versus Michigan party. So, you'll see, this is my family. majority of them like Michigan. I don't know why, but you know, Michigan lose every year. But this was my lasagna that I did, and then this is the chicken smoked and then baked and then barbecue. These the ribs. I don't eat and baked and then barbecue. These the ribs. I don't eat pork. I don't know. This is for chicken sandwiches. Got corn, beans, some kind of dip, macaroni salad, chips.
That's okay, that's cool, it's normal, a man's gonna try.
But we ain't ready to give you one. We got to go.
But you don't want us to leave, so you're gonna try to make us feel guilty.
Girl, you leaving? How you gonna
stay? That's what I used to marinate my steak. Herbs and garlic. This is my special blend of seasoning. Lemon pepper, garlic, and seasoned salt. And some potatoes and onions. I really like potatoes and onions. Especially when it's made right. Yep, but today, steak.
That's okay, that's cool, it's normal, a man's gonna try.
But we ain't ready to give you one. We got to go.
But you don't want us to leave, so you're gonna try to make us feel guilty.
Girl, you leaving? How you gonna leave? You gonna leave me like this?
Fry me some shrimp. The real shrimp, you know, the head on. Oh, this is definitely a glad sight to see. Chicken fajitas. But I don't. I had to separate from that one. I'm single. Where I did steak. And so it's a lemon pepper, and it is a garlic herb marinade. And then, of course, you know, I got my vegetables. I let it marinate since like 9. Where I did steak. And so it's a lemon pepper, and it is a garlic herb marinade. And then, of course, you know, I got my vegetables. I let it marinate since like 9 this morning. And I just put it in the pan now, so I'm about to put this lid over it.
I'm trying to talk to you, sugar.
Talk to us, Patty. Talk. These yams is coming together pretty good too in my crock pot. And then I decided to go with some broccoli. I don't know nobody that can do that. It's my baked chicken. Green cheese. My fried chicken. So today, well, on today's menu, nothing extravagant, just baking some chicken, salad, and I don't like all the stuff that other people like in a salad, so I like my salads to be a little bit bland, I guess. Some hamburger helper. Now this is a classic. I grew up in the hood, so yeah, it would always be hamburger helper when it's to smash that shit. It's good if you definitely know how to make it right. Anybody want some fresh wingdings? Fresh wingdings. Some hot sauce. Today I'm in the kitchen, I'm getting my little meal on. That's what I'm doing today. Got my little beef boneless ribs, cabbage, and I'm gonna be doing some yams. That's what I'm on today. Hope everybody having a blessed. That's what I'm on today. Hope everybody having a blessed day.
Specific explanations on why pork is forbidden in Islam and Christianity you didn't know about. 1. Pigs carry about 30 diseases which can easily be passed to humans. This is why Allah commanded us to not even touch their carcass. 2. Pigs.
Yams looking like so far. Then I'm cooking my turkey leg. Cooking my turkey leg. Dinner is dinnering. from where I'm at, so. So I have some greens, turkey meat, cabbage, okra. And I'm gonna do some beef ribs, a boneless style. Transferring it from the pot to the crock pot. Put some barbecue sauce on those. My dinner is done. Thank you for taking this journey with me. Watching my little video. Thank you for taking this journey with me. Watching my little video. Me preparing my meal. So these are my little beef boneless ribs. Dinner coming together. Hope you're having a good day. Well, today I have some au gratin potatoes, and then to go along with my meatloaf. I only cover one side so far. I like, because I wanted to show it without the sauce. And with the sauce. That's what I'm eating on today. Hope everybody's having a blessed day. My baked chicken. Onions, crushed red pepper. Marinated in herb and garlic and lemon pepper marinade. Now I like to broil my chicken, so I like mine's a little crispy. That's just me though. And then this is last minute, so I did some rice, put some butter and sugar in that. Then I have my creamy garlic pasta, whatever. Normally I do a vegetable. I was gonna do some potatoes and onions, but I didn't have enough time, so about to smash. Hope y'all having a blessed day. Stay positive. Remember, you are worthy, I am worthy, and we deserve. And I'm so glad that Mercury retrograde is over. Mercury retrograde. Man, look at how my steak came out. I'm still about to smash, but man, look at how my steak came out. My T-bone steak and some potatoes and onions. I love potatoes and onions. If you can't tell. And it's just me, so I was gonna do a vegetable like a broccoli and cheese or something like that, but it's just me, so. Ketchup, barbecue sauce, and steak sauce. Wingdings! Fresh.
Little snack, you know, little snack for chicken.
Fresh out the grease. Man, my wings shit on Wingstop or Wingspot or BW3's, Buffalo Wild Wings, all that shit. Man, my wings shits on their wings, okay? These were seasoned with Lawry's. And I actually put the seasoning on the meat, not in my flour. I can't stand that shit. When people put seasonings in their flour, oh god, that is just so annoying. Yeah, but my wings was shit on. I put my wings up against anybody's wings, like, and then I haven't even covered them with like barbecue sauce. Of course, like, I use Red Hots and stuff like that if people want like buffalo wings, but I don't eat spicy foods, so I just do barbecue sauce. Honey barbecue sauce. Man, I don't go. See, I just put some barbecue sauce. Sweet Baby Ray's honey barbecue. I'm about to eat all of these. It's just me, so. And then the rest, you know, whatever.